Hi there, it's Kevin with the Rogue Market here with the November Pirates Plunder Pick Update. Periodically, I will give my 2 cents on sealed product or other product that you can snag if you are a patron that I think are good deals. So I usually do this monthly. People have asked me to do this bi-monthly, so I'll probably do that. And I think this month especially, or coming into December, is going to be very important for the Pirate Plunders tier if you are a patron. I think this is also pretty good information for people who aren't patrons. First of all, let's explain what it is to be a patron of the Rogue Deck Builder / the Rogue Market. This is kind of like you scratch my back, I'll scratch your back. We have different tiers that you can support the channel, and it really starts to make it worth it if you're at the $10 or above tier. At $8, you're allowed to buy the latest booster box or bundle at distributor cost for a box opening on camera. So what I'll do is I'll open up the booster box, and we will do a little, usually a profit or loss video that goes on my Gone Rogue Games channel. And then I'll ship you the common or the uncommons and rares at free shipping, and you just pay the cost of the bundle or the booster box. It gives some content for my channel, and it's a way for you to get some cheap sealed product. Typically, bundles are $25 and booster boxes are like $85. I can get them for cheaper sometimes, but for buying one particular box, that's usually the cost that it costs for me to get them. Then at the $10 tier, this is where you're allowed to buy 2 products per month, whether it be usually I suggest you buy booster boxes at that point. It really gets juicy when you get to the $20, and that's what we call it, the Pirate's Plunder, and that's why this video is called the Pirate's Plunder Pick, because I'm going to go over the products that I think are very good investments at this time period. So at the $20 tier, you get 6 products, and then for every $5, you get 6 more, all the way up to unlimited if you join the $100 tier. At that point, we consider you to be basically shareholders in the Gone Rogue Games store. So without further ado, let's get into the Pirate Plunder's picks for November. So November is kind of slow right off the bat. In fact, there haven't been any good sales, but I think that's going to be changing. So this video is going to be more of the same as it was last October. But again, in about 2 weeks, I think we're going to start seeing a lot of sales with Black Friday and the Cyber Monday. And then I'll post these on the Patreon for patrons to then look, and then I'll get them ordered and shipped off. So for this month, I still like the Core 2020 pre-release packs. I think this is a great deal. If you actually look at the price of the average pre-release stamped foil, it is about $4 or $5. So that is actually more than another booster pack. So you're going to get more EV from the stamped foil than you are from another pack. So if you break it down as if you're getting more than 6 packs, so you're getting the 6 packs and the stamped foil, that the cost of these is actually cheaper than if you go the booster box route for cracking singles. I like Core 2020. It's got almost $7 uncommon at this point. It's got some mythics that I think are poised to go up in the Pioneer format, and it definitely has some great standard cards that still have a long time in the standard format. So Core 2020 is the set that I like the most in standard, and I think it's going to be looked back on as the best core set ever, or at least the best core set since the 2012s and the 2011s. In this time period, if you are looking at comparing it to 2019, 2018, Origins, all those ones, Core 2020 is definitely the best core set. And core sets are the least opened out of all the sets in standard, and that makes the individual cards able to hold a lot higher prices than if they were put in something like Throne of Eldraine. All right, so on to the next one is Modern Horizons at 163. This product did take a hit over the weekend with Pioneer. Pioneer's been sapping a lot of value from Modern into Pioneer, and Modern Horizons sales have really slowed down. eBay prices have gone significantly down. You've even seen places like Dave and Adams that have chopped the value of Modern Horizons down to like the 180s. So 163 doesn't look as a good deal as it once was, but the supply of these, I think, is starting to dry up. I don't think that Battle Bond lasted more than about November. I think they did one more like short printing between the November and February periods, but it was February that Battle Bond really started to take off. And I think Modern Horizons is going to be the same as Battle Bond. This does probably have more supply than Battle Bond because they initially used both printers to print Modern Horizons. So you can tell because some of the boxes will have the rares in front and some will have the rares in back. One of those is coming through European and one's coming from the American printer. They just have a different way of actually assembling them into the packs. But Modern Horizons, I think, is going to be one of the premier sets going forward for Modern. It has a lot of staples in it. If you actually compare it to other Master sets, Modern Horizons is packed full of value in that set. So I like it at 163. Don't know how long that deal is going to last. For an old set, I like Corset 2014. Corset 2014, you're not going to get the value back by cracking the packs, but at 110, this is one of the last booster boxes around that 100-110 range before you start getting into like the... It tends to have a jump. Once it hits about 110, the next jump goes about 150. And you'll see like boxes like Kaladesh and Khans of Tarkir have really skyrocketed. And they didn't have a long time period where they sat in that, you know, the 120s, 130s range. So I think Corset 2014 at 110 is a good deal. It might get up to the 150s by the end of the year. There are a lot of great staples for Pioneer in this set, like Scavenging Ooze or Young Pyromancer or Mutavault. Those all typically do tend to get reprinted often, but I don't know if they are going to be reprinting things like Mutavault anytime soon. They don't want it in standard. The way they're printing their Modern Horizons with new cards might make it difficult with Mutavault, and it's just something I don't see them putting in a Commander product. Had that GP promo. I think it's done for a while, so that will have some equity towards the Core 2014, especially if it becomes such a pivotal staple in Pioneer. I like it at that price point at 110. Guilds of Ravnica 85 is the standard booster box that I'd invest in right now. This is the one that is being purchased like crazy, and I think it's because people have realized that shocks are the new fetches in the Pioneer format, and this is the best place to get at least half the shocks, so you can actually keep in mind that Ravnica Allegiance will be the other half. But Guilds of Ravnica as a whole has the Assassin trophies. It has a better, I think, just a much better list of cards than the Ravnica Allegiance. Ravnica Allegiance has better standard cards, but I think Guilds of Ravnica has better long-term commander cards, and I mean Smothering Tithe, I guess, was in Ravnica Allegiance too, but commander cards and modern cards and pioneer cards, I think Guilds is the way to go. So this one is just flying off the shelves. I'm doing a lot of orders of Guilds of Ravnica, which is funny because I wasn't doing any for a while there, and now people are requesting this more and more. So I don't know how long this price point is actually going to last with Guilds of Ravnica either. We're at this time period where Wizards isn't quite print to demand anymore, so that means that if this does go out of stock before it rotates out of standard, they might just go what they did with Dominaria and be like, oh well, it's out of print, we're not doing another wave. So Guilds of Ravnica, I think, will be the first one to go, like the Dominaria. All right, then last but not least is definitely Iconic Masters at 180. This has been going up about $5 per month for my Iconic Masters, and I think this is another set that is going to be known as a pretty decent one. Of course, it was dismal when they announced it, and then, of course, Masters 25 came out, and it was just another they shot themselves in the foot there. But out of the two sets, out of the last two Masters, or the Iconic and the Masters 25, I actually prefer Iconic. It's got better uncommons. It has a better rare slots. It doesn't have Jace the Mind Sculptor or any of those really, really expensive mythics, but it does have some goodies that are in the set. So I think this is the last time you're going to be able to get under 200. I think at the end of the year, this will spike back up. And especially once we go through the market craze in the tax return season, I think that Iconic Masters will be scooped up and there won't be any at this price. So this is the last time to really get in on this price. I also do have core the bundles available for all of these, which I still think are a pretty decent value for Eldritch Moon and Core 2020, or not Eldritch Moon, Throne of Eldraine. Wish I could get Eldritch Moon bundles. Throne of Eldraine and Core 2020 are still pretty good pickups for the bundles. So speaking of all the other things, we still don't have a restock date for Commander 2019 or Brawl, but I've had rumors that it's mid-November, so we're getting close to mid-November. So for Brawl decks and Commander 2019, typically I can get those. So if you're looking for those particular products, that is an option. And we also do have options for other things like commonly ordered things like the alternate art Weeb Playmask from Ultra Pro for $14. Those are the Japanese alternate art ones. Dragon Shield Sleeves about $6.50, Ultra Pro Sleeves for about $6. The Alco boxes for $15. Legion Defenders and other perfect fits range between $2 to $3. And the Ultimate Guard products end up being about, you know, 40 to 45% off their MSRP price. So again, it's not the craziest deals ever. I like to say if you want to be a patron, it's a way of, you know, supporting a channel and getting some perks at the time. So it really helps me out, and I think it's a great service. So if you want to be a part of a local game store and get these distributor prices, definitely think about going and signing up for Patreon. So again, I'll be doing another update when we get closer to the Black Friday sales, and if there is anything that does pique my interest or something that does come under the radar, I will definitely post it on the Patreon account. So hope you enjoyed this video, and if you are in the market for sealed product, just give me a message and we'll get it ordered. This has been Kevin with the Rogue Market. Thanks for watching.